They call it a moment of clarity, and it comes at the darndest times. There is a moment as Humbarine burns beneath the blaster bolts and turbo laser bolts of the separatist fleet, entire astronomical units further into the system, when Task Force 13 destroys the last of the separatist ships near the jump point out of Humbarine, when the last of the refugees have jumped to hyperspace, there is a moment of clarity. For a handful of minutes, no enemy ships are close enough to fire upon you. For a handful of minutes, no allied survivors can see you. For these minutes, the Separatist fleet is completely occupied with the destruction of Humbarine. In all of the chaos of the Clone Wars for the last year and a half of endless fighting, in the midst of the greatest tragedy that the heroes have witnessed, they have a moment of clarity. A moment in which all of the outside forces of the universe have no traction upon them. Everyone is looking somewhere else. And in and of itself, Task Force 13, this fleet of liberated clones, freed in secret after a year of adventuring by the Jedi, a fleet everyone knows is equipped with experimental, potentially faulty hyperdrives. A fleet which forced itself out of dry dock ahead of time on an hour's notice. A fleet of young heroes who have just saved 60 million people. But the last sight that any Republic survivor will have had of them, if they do nothing else, is of Task Force 13 deployed around the jump point, holding the line under Separatist attack to preserve the last of the 60 million refugees from Humbarine. And for the first time since the Jedi plucked them from their families, no one can tell them what to do. And the Force-sensitive Jedi feel that they stand at a crossroads they had not even known existed. But it's here. At this moment, for the very first time, as a result of their heroism and their hard work and their deceptions and all of the risks and all of the investments, all of the times they've put their lives on the line, in this moment, three young Jedi and their faithful and surly droid can choose their own destiny. They can reform the fleet and jump from Humbarine into Republic space, guarding the refugees and guiding them to safety and rejoining the Grand Army of the Republic. And they can sense that along that path lies great battles where they will be hurled against impossible odds, but retaking the worlds of Dirge's lances, hunting down the Dark Jedi, perhaps even facing the famous generals such as Dirge and Grievous. The fights that they know, the path that they were raised for, a path that they have discovered is the machination of the Sith themselves. That they are not, in effect, fighting for the freedom of the universe, but they're one of two parts of a chess game that Emperor Pal that Senator Palpatine has been playing against himself. Or they could jump into wild space. They, as you know, years, more than a year ago, they've discovered holomaps of an entire sector full of lost star systems, the ancient holdings of the Anorian Jedi and the Ombacan sector, which could use a hero. And disappear beyond, you know, they could take a step away from this false, you know, from this trap of, from this trap. They could do it. And in the chaos of the Clone Wars, hey, maybe they just didn't make the jump. Perhaps Task Force 13 wasn't able to escape the Separatist fleet that they had made the ultimate sacrifice buying the, refugees' time. No one could prove otherwise. Everyone is looking the other way. For these minutes, everyone is looking the other way. The Jedi Council is blinded by the veil of the dark side. Palpatine is probably, you know, rolling around in ecstasy at the sensation of the deaths of 1.5 trillion. He's certainly not paying attention to three teenage Jedi. The paths are endless. They can, our heroes can continue to play out the drama, you know, head for the destiny that the Jedi chose for them and that Palpatine has set up for them. But they have already freed their clones from the chips. They have from the control chips. They have already financed the warships. They have built this veteran battle fleet and seen them to victory and from victory on victory. They have the loyalty of their men. They could just go and take a quarter million clones and other sentients into freedom, away from all of this, perhaps into wild space, perhaps into the unknown regions. Who knows? They could engage the they could try to engage the cloaking devices and disappear entirely. Perhaps the technology works, perhaps it doesn't. They could be captured. The if they wait too long, if they do nothing, then eventually enough separatists will surround them to overcome them and either capture our heroes or kill them. So there is a potential for a darker end of the story, and they could choose that route. The fate and the grief of all of the pain that's washing over them could tempt them to the dark side, and they could fall. And they could defect. Having seen the terrible corruption that has now let the corruption and inefficiency of the Republic, which has now let their adopted homeworld burn in front of their very eyes, rather than commit fresh forces to defend them, they could decide that the cause of liberty and freedom from the from a central galactic government is worth fighting and dying for. And who knows? Maybe they would be able to escape the influence of the Sith. Maybe Dooku would allow them their freedom in exchange for them contributing a fleet. Maybe. But whatever path they choose, by their heroism, by escaping Humbarine, in this moment, more than any time in their living memory, the young Jedi heroes stand at a crossroads. Their story, the destiny of which they were not even aware, was that of young Padawans growing to adulthood in the middle of a galactic civil war of shattering proportions, and then perhaps surviving Palpatine's trap of Order 66. This was the story that their lives were going to tell. But they can choose for their lives to take a different path. They can go somewhere where they are the light, where the galactic powers overlook them or cannot see them. There is no telling. Or they could decide that they are Jedi. They have discovered Palpatine's plot. They know about the control chips. They have a cure. There are still roughly 4,000 active Jedi. They could rally 4,000 Keepers of the Republic and confront Palpatine directly, ignore the false threat or the manufactured threat of the Separatists, perhaps even give the Separatists their freedom and end the war and focus on the Sith Lord who is trying to take over the galaxy. Instead of waiting for Palpatine to choose the time, they could make the fight against the Sith right now. And head to Coruscant, head to the Council, rally the Jedi Masters, fight alongside them against the actual evil that threatens the galaxy. Perhaps, they could even save the Jedi Order. Who knows what they could do? And in this handful of moments, our young Jedi heroes stand at that crossroads, a crossroads they could not even imagine. Down one path, they can turn the sham civil war of the Clone Wars into a genuine conflict of the Jedi versus the Sith. On another, they can leave this doomed and futile machination of a war behind them and try to find their own separate peace. Perhaps they could change sides. They can decide that the Force, when the living Force put them on the path that they were meant to, and embrace their position with the Grand Army of the Republic, trusting that they and their troops will live through the conflict, and that when Order 66 comes, they will be prepared to survive it, since they have done everything possible to give them every advantage. There is an infinite number of possibilities, but the Clone Wars for our heroes could end today. Or they could embrace it and live the lives of champions of the Republic however long they have left. Because they believe in loyalty and duty and honor, and if good Jedi don't stand up for the innocent in worlds like Humbarine, and they simply run to find their own peace, what will they do? But if they stay and fight, what will they accomplish when the fight itself has been rigged from the beginning by the very Sith Lord who engineered it? So many choices at the crossroads, and a handful of minutes for our young Jedi to choose what path their future will hold. It is almost as if, in response for saving 60 million souls, the Living Force has handed a brief flickering gift to our young Jedi heroes. A gift not given to many in the Star Wars universe, in this galaxy far, far away. The chance to choose their own story. I wonder what story will they choose?